Now the recording has started now. Yes, what are we supposed to do? We are supposed to do this lesson that is here. Starting small. Beginnings. Beginnings means what? Beginnings means Shuruaat. And Shuruaat kaisi honi chahiye? What type of beginning should we have? We should always start small. Be it a business or be it any relationship, we should start on a small scale and then we should go up. We should try and increase it. That is good. And this is means whenever you read any success story or come to know about success story of any businessman or any person in the world, they all started very small and they touched the sky, right? And that is called success. So here also we are gonna just learn the story of KFC and McDonald's. I hope you people must have gone through the story before you came here. So did you find the story be very impressive? Harlan Sanders, KFC. Actually, I did not know the full form of KFC before I read this story. This story first time told me what KFC stands for. Kentucky Fried Chicken. Yes. Has anyone of you tasted KFC chickens? Yeah, you're a regular visitor. Prakash sir is a regular visitor, and Mrs. Veer can never eat because she is complete vegetarian. Rajnandini is also vegetarian. Burger, okay. Vegetarian burger. How does it taste, Mrs. Veer?
Very tasty.
Very tasty. What a special did you find it in? In it?
Different flavor, sir.
Different flavor. What special ingredient did you notice in their burger? Could you notice something special?
No.
Rajnandini. Prakash sir, what do you like KFC chicken for, especially? Okay. Juicy also inside. Crispy and juicy at the same time, right, sir? Rajnandini, have you ever tasted anything from KFC restaurants?
No.
Manya, what about you?
Right now, no,
sir. From McDonald's, guys? Rajnandini and Manya? Right now, not. Till now. Abhi tak. Till now, nothing. I've never been to. I've never visited McDonald's or KFC. Rajesh, sir, what about you? Chicken, KFC chicken recipe, and others. Okay, and that's why it is selling in 80 countries. Okay. Yes, Prakash sir's voice is not clear. From tomorrow, I'll take care of it. Yes, it is clear now. It is clearer now. Okay, you started. Great. Okay. It's a lot like pakodi. Then what is the maja of eating chicken if there is no smell of chicken? I'm wilder than anybody here. Yeah, okay. Its size is also different. Is it really chicken or something else? Or they are selling in the name of chicken something. It's only chicken, okay. So okay, but frog's leg is also exactly like chicken's leg. You must know, sir. Mrs. Veer, it's just a topic. Today's topic it is. Good. No, 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 no. What about you, Gunjan? Have you ever visited McDonald's or KFC? KFC and both. So, are you a regular visitor? Okay, occasionally you visit. Okay. So, which dish from KFC and McDonald's do you like the most? Your voice is not clear, I think. Your voice is not clear. Now it is clear. Yes, sir was clear. Yes, sir was clear. Yeah, now your voice clear. No, now your voice is clear. Chicken wing. Oh, what is that? No, I'm not talking about its taste. I want to know what exactly is that chicken wing? Is it the wings of the chicken? Is it the wings of the chicken? Okay. They cook that also. Okay. See, I'm very desi type. I like only chicken curry or chicken kadahi. Other dishes of chicken I don't like. I have tested. No, I have never visited to KFC. I've never visited KFC. I've never visited McDonald's. I don't like visiting restaurants. Okay, but I've tested. And Sanaya, what about you, dear? Sanaya, can you hear me? You have never visited. Okay, no issue. Are you vegetarian or non-vegetarian? Both. Both. Sorry, sir. Means he eats both things, vegetarian dishes and non-vegetarian dishes also. But generally, people who eat chicken and meat are called non-vegetarian, and those who don't eat at all are called vegetarian. Okay, you are Radha Pandit ji. Like my wife is. My wife also eats only eggs and fishes. She never eats mutton and chicken. So all of you have gone through the story, right? Okay. Then are you ready for the question answer? Okay, I'm gonna ask the question one by one. One by one, everybody will answer. What fast food companies are there in your country? No, I'm not gonna ask are there in your country. I will ask are there in your town or city? What fast food companies are there in your town or city? And what do they sell? One by one. Starting from Abhishek. Very good, very good. What about you, Gunjan? Gunjan. Okay, at Bihar, see if you don't know any such place, okay? And Mumbai is full of such outlets, right? In the Mumbai, no, in Mumbai. In Patna also, of course. Okay. I think most of you people are very much fond of market food, right? You're not. Abhishek is not. Mania, what fast food companies are there in your city? And what do they sell? Very good. CCD, that is called Cafe Coffee Dinner, right? I think most of the people know it by the name of CCD instead of full name Cafe Coffee Day, right? Okay. How many of these places have you visited, Manya, in your city? Which of these places? And what did you eat there?
Sir, in Domino's, I usually eat pizza and...
Doesn't your mom prepare cook pizza at home?
No.
Okay. Good. And after Manya, I'm going to Rajnandini. Rajnandini? You are also from Bihar Sharif. I never visit restaurants, so I don't know much about it. Though I am also from Bihar Sharif itself. So will you please tell me what so you also don't have any idea which fast food companies are there at Bihar Sharif, right? Okay. And because you are vegetarian, you don't have much choice, means don't have fondness for some non-vegetarian food in the market, available in the market, right? No issue. Rajesh sir, you are in Patna. So what fast food companies are there in Patna, and especially which of them have you visited? Rajesh sir knows the names of these outlets or restaurants. It clearly shows that he is very much fond of the things. Not regularly, occasionally. Okay, yeah, you visit occasionally, right? Sanaya, I think you're not gonna answer this question. Or will you try? Okay, if you don't know about fast food companies, which famous restaurants are there in your town, Sanaya? And what are they famous for? Oh, you never buy market food. Amazing, great, great. Mrs. Veer. Which fast food companies are there in your town?
Sir, in my town there is Hoppers, KFC, McDonald's, Pizza Hut,
Domino's. Most of them are there, right?
Yes.
And what do they sell?
They sell burger, pizza.
And how often do you visit them? Once in a 50-10.
Twice in a month.
And what generally do you eat there? And which of them do you like most from service point of view? And no, I am asking from service point of view. I'm not asking from the recipes, from recipes point of view. Yes, which restaurant services? Okay. Yeah. And so far as environment is concerned, which is the best one?
Domino's.
Why do you like that most? Great, great. And that's why you like that more, okay?
Yes.
And which one of them is the worst, according to you?
I don't like Subway.
Why don't you like that?
Because of their taste.
Okay, they provide tasteless. Still they are running, right?
Yes.
Why so?
My husband is fond of Subway, sir.
Okay, means you want to say that your husband's taste is not good. That's why I wanted to ask the same question next. After that. Okay. They are known for the quality, means nutritious value of their food, right? Great, great. And which of them is the most costly or costliest?
McDonald's.
And which of them is the least expensive? Great, great. Amazing. So 100 rupees is very... It means not expensive, right, for one burger. Okay, least expensive. Yes, for Abhishek also, for Abhishek and Rajesh sir also. But I think means it's very tough for me to spend 100 rupees for one burger only. But anyways, yes, I can understand. I was just moving to the question number second, guys. Ready for that? Because the second and third part we have already done. What are the good and bad things about? No, second is not done. So this is very important question. What are the good and bad things about fast food? What are good things about fast food? It also tastes good. Will anybody say anything else about the good qualities and yeah, please. It saves times, okay? What do you say, Manya? Yes, sir. Yeah, it. Especially for liver. It causes obesity also. Obesity, OBESITB. Obesity means? Yes. Fatness, motapa. It causes obesity. One fact I must share with all of you, that the needle injection needle used in America is a little longer than the injection needle used in the other parts of the world, because the fat layer of fat is thicker in the body of the Americans than in the body of other country people. Because I'm telling you, the needle of the length of the injection needle used in America is longer than the length, or more than the length of the injection needle used in other countries. Why? Because the layer of fat below the skin of the Americans is thicker, much thicker. Yeah, because of the habit of eating fast food. They also eat very many kinds of processed food, because generally husband and wife both are working, and that's why there is no one to prepare fresh meal at home, and that's why they use canned and processed meal and fast food also. Okay. Sorry, sir. Okay, I did not know that. It's a really new kind of information for me. they don't have any kitchen in their houses. Should we move to the second question? Are you ready? Read the article about KFC and Harlan Sanders. Put the events in order. There are six sentences given here. A, B, C, D, E, and F. You'll have to rearrange those sentences in correct sequence. Okay, in correct chronological sequence. What will be the first one? Which will be the first one? His father died. B number. Okay. And second sentence in the arrangement? F. He learned to cook. Correct. And third number? Correct. And fourth number? Very good. And fifth number? And the last one is A. Right? Very good. Read the article again, then answer these questions. See, all these things, through this chapter, you are practicing past indefinite tense. Through this chapter, you are practicing past indefinite tense. In all most of the sentences, you can see second form of the verb. And if the sentence is negative, you will see did not and then first form of the verb. And if the sentence is interrogative, again did with first form of the verb. Could you notice these things while reading the story and the chapter at home? Did you watch the video that I provided you on the app about this lesson? In that video, I tried to draw your attention towards the tense, past indefinite or simple past. Okay? Highlighting the second forms of the verb in the story given. Okay. Read the article and then answer these questions. Okay? My first question is to Rajnandini. Why did Harlan Sanders learn to cook when he was a child?
Harlan Sanders learned to cook because he has to look after his younger brother and sister.
Because you're talking about the past. He had to look after. Okay? Sanaya. Okay, leave. Sanaya is not ready. Abhishek. That made him learn to cook when he was young. Rajesh sir, you didn't read it, sir. Okay. Prakash sir. Okay, very good, sir. Very good. Mrs. Veer, I want the answer of the same question from you.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. His father died when he was a child, and his mother had to do a job, and there was no one to look after his younger brother and sister. Mm-hmm. So, for that, sir, he had to learn.
Very good. Yes. Prakash sir made a simple mistake, a small mistake, that he said had to stayed. No sir, had to stay. The recording is being done. You can just listen to it after it is published. Okay. Manya. Very good. And his father died. Dead is an adjective. Dead means mara hua, and died means guzar gaye, mar gaye. So die is a very harsh word. Okay, if you want to show some respect towards somebody who has died, then you should use passed away. You should use passed away. This is just information, a new learning for you. Okay? उसके पिताजी मर गए और उसके पिताजी गुजर गए. Which of these two sentences is more respectful? Tell me. गुजर गए ना. In the same way, his father died is not so much respectful as his father passed away. Okay? So one new thing for you people. Okay, moving to the second question, and Prakash sir will give the first answer. Answer first. Okay? How long did it take him to develop his secret recipe, chicken recipe, sir? Your voice is again not clear, sir. Okay, Mrs. Veer.
Yes, sir. It took him 9 years, sir.
Gunjan. Okay, Manya. Sanaya. Abhishek. Yes, all of you gave the same answer, but all of you practiced one structure, right? It took him and then time and then the work, right? It took him 9 years to develop. Okay, moving to the next question. When did the first official KFC restaurant open? And the question goes to, first of all, Sanaya. I think she is not answering. Okay. Mrs. Veer. Can you hear me, Mrs. Veer? Please, next question is for you. First, when did the first official KFC restaurant open?
First KFC was opened in August 1954.
Okay. Manya.
The first official KFC restaurant opened in 1954.
Very good. I am very happy that you are making the sentences correctly according to the tense. You are using the right form of the verb today. Correct form of the verb, Manya. And Prakash sir. Okay. Rajnandini. Okay, Tejasu, did you read the story, dear? Tejasu, did?
Yes,
okay, will you please answer this question? When did the first official KFC restaurant open?
First official KFC restaurant opened in August 1952.
Mm-hmm. Very good. And Abhishek now. Abhishek. Yeah, please, Mrs. Veer.
Sir, in the para, there is open until August
1952. Mm-hmm. So, it opened after that. I was to explain it after everybody's answer, okay? I did not say anything about anybody's answer, whether it is right or wrong. I am just listening to everybody's answer, and after that I was going to explain what it means by until. It did not open until August 1952. Okay, so it did not open until August 1952 means it opened after that. Okay, it opened after that. Means it opened in September 1952 or 54, whatever year is given there, but not until August 1952. So, moving to the next question. How old was Harlan Sanders when he sold the company? How How old was Harlan Sanders when he sold the company? Prakash sir is saying he was 74. Okay. What you say, Mrs. Veer? He was 90 years. Okay. Okay. Manya? Yes, yes. Manya, do you have any answer to this question?
Yes, sir. He was 74 years old when he sold the company.
Abhishek, who is correct? Manya and Prakash sir is correct. Both are correct. Now the next question goes to Tejaswa. What happened in 1980, Tejas? What happened in 1980? Beta, angreji mein boliye. Don't say Hindi. I don't remember. I don't have to remember. You can just look at the story and tell me also after seeing the story. Because this information is not going to be useful for any of your examination. This is just only meant to give you an opportunity to make some sentences, nothing else, okay? Prakash sir, what happened in 1980? Who died? I will definitely send this... And this question goes to Abhishek. Who bought KFC in 1986? Mrs. Veer.
Yes, sir.
In 1986. Both of you are correct. Both of you are correct. Very good. Now moving to question number third. Do you know what regular verbs are and what irregular verbs are? Will you please explain it to me, Mrs.
Yes, sir.
You are correct, Mrs. V, but your language was not so precise. Okay? And Abhishek, I want you to explain the same thing. Regular verbs and irregular verbs. What are regular verbs and what are irregular verbs? Do you have any idea, Abhishek? Okay, okay, no problem. No problems. I will explain, don't worry. Tejas, do you have any idea? I think. Yeah, please tell me what are regular verbs? You explained it a little better. Very good. Manya, do you have... Yes, yes. Manya, do you have any idea about regular and irregular verbs?
No, sir.
Okay. Let me explain it to all of you. Okay? In a simpler language. See, all the verbs have second and third forms. Is it right?
Right, sir.
What is the second form of play? Played, we add ed to it, and what is the third form of play? What is the third form? Played itself. Okay. What is the second form of test? T-A-S-T. What is the second? Tested. Again we added ed, right? But e is already there in the end of that verb. We added d, right? And what is the third form of test? Tested again. So, okay. But will you please tell me now What is the second form of go? And what is the third form of go? Gone. Okay. So what difference did you find? That there are two categories of verbs. In one category, there are some certain verbs which can be changed into second form or third form only by adding D or ED. Right? They are known as regular verbs. Means they don't have anything special to make into second form and third form. So they follow the regular routine, the regular rule. Okay? That's why they are regular verbs. But there are some other verbs also in the English language which cannot be changed into second and third forms by adding D or ED, like go. You cannot say goed, goed. It is wrong. You'll have to say went, go, went and gone. Okay. Similarly, cut. Cut is a verb which is changed into second form by not adding anything. Yeah, it remains the same, cut, and in the third form also it remains the same, cut. What about leave, L-E-A-V-E? Its second form is left and third form is also left. Okay, so these verbs never take D or ED to be changed into second form or third form. And that's why they are known as irregular verbs, because they don't follow any regular pattern in their past forms and past participle forms. Am I clear to everybody? Do I need to explain the things in Hindi? Sure. In English itself or in Hindi do you want, Manya? Okay, dear. See, when we add D or ED to form the second or third forms of any verb, those verbs are known as regular verbs. Like play. Its second form is played and third form is also played. We added ED to make it into second and third form, past and past participle forms. Okay, so it is a regular verb. But there are some other verbs which never follow any regular pattern. Okay, who is hissing into the mic? okay. Okay, so irregular verbs are the verbs which can be changed into second and third form, but not by adding or taking D or ED. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is known as irregular verb. Should I move ahead? Okay. Tell me, is be a regular or irregular verb? Okay, very good. Because its second form is was and third form is been. It is not changed into second and third form with the help of D or ED. Okay, that's why it is irregular. And what about can?
Irregular.
What is the second form of can? It has no third form. All the models have only present form and past form. They don't have any past participle form. Okay. And how do we make the negative of be in the past tense? No. See, be is the main verb and its V2 is was. And its negative is was not. Am I clear to everybody?
Yes.
Okay. B is the main form. Its second form is was. And its negative is was not. Generally in simple past, it does not happen so. Generally in simple past, to form a negative sentence, we use did as an auxiliary verb. And we use not after did. We use not with did, not with the main verb. Here, not is being used with the main verb be when it is in the second form. Am I clear? Okay. And what about can? How will you just change it into negative? In the past form? In the past? Couldn't. Okay. I hope it is quite clear to everybody now. The day before yesterday, I couldn't sleep whole night. I don't know. There was no reason. I kept working whole night on computer. Maybe. Generally, how do we make the negative of past simple? With did. By using not with, did. And which form of the verb is used in the negative form? In the negative sentences of past? Be one. Very good. Can you give any example? Okay. But some people make a mistake. They say, I didn't went to market. Is it right? It's wrong. We should not say we didn't went. We should say we didn't, I didn't do, we didn't do, he didn't do, like that, right? Didn't do. And how to make its interrogative? Same questions. By putting did before the subject, right? Did you take breakfast today, guys? And did you take lunch? Okay. Yes, Mrs. Veer, I took. Yes. Yes. And how to make the questions with verb be? By putting was just before the subject. Was he sad? How do we make past simple questions with the verb be? We put was before the subject. Was he sad yesterday?
Yes.
Was he ready to help you? Who was it?
Yes, sir, he was.
Yes. So I hope now it is quite clear. Moving to the question number 4. Okay. You'll have to tell me the second form of the verbs that I tell you. What is the second form of the verb die? Died. Need. Needed. Stay. Stayed. Learn. Learned. Worked. Work. Worked. Start.
Started.
Started. Say with me, started. Yeah. Some people are in the habit of saying it started. Is it started? No. It is started. 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 Move. Moved. Moved. Okay. Develop. Developed. Decide. Decided. Continued. Visited. See, some people are in the habit of saying visited. Isn't it? It's not so. Visited. Yeah. Traveled. Okay. And to be assured, to be confirmed, to learn it perfectly, you can practice with the recording 2.1. That is there on the app already. Play the pronunciation of these verbs, second form of these verbs, and try to speak along with them. First, listen to them carefully in the first round, and from the second round, try to speak with them. Try to match the pronunciation. Okay? Please try to do it at home. As much as you can. See, Question number in fifth. Question number fifth A. It is said, read about McDonald's. Fill in gaps from 1 to 11 with the past simple of the verbs in brackets. See, where is the McDonald's story given? It is given here, right? And there is a serial number for every blank, isn't there? And beside the blank, there is a verb given in bracket. What you have to do? You'll have to fill the blank, fill in the blank with the second form of the verb given here. Okay. So 10 years before KFC sold its first chicken dinner, the first McDonald's restaurant opened. Means which restaurant opened first? KFC or McDonald's? How long before KFC? 10 years before KFC. So which is older? KFC or McDonald's? McDonald's is older. Okay. And who is younger brother? KFC, yes. Okay. In California, Dick and Morris McDonald sold burgers for 15 cents, yeah, and milkshakes for 20 cents. It is very, 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 very cheap. People did not have much time. Did not have much time for lunch. So they did not want to wait long for their meal. At the first McDonald's, customers could get their food in 15 seconds. This was the beginning of cheap fast food. In 1955, a man called Ray Kroc became an agent, became second form, an agent for McDonald's and started opening restaurants in other states. The McDonald brothers were not very ambitious, and so Ray Kroc bought the company. Okay, when you say bout, its spelling will become bout, and it means wrestling, kusti. Okay, bought the company for $2.7 million in 1961. In the 60s, he opened over 1,000 new restaurants, and now there are more than 25,000 McDonald's in over 120 countries. I hope everybody is correct.
Yes, sir.
I hope you must have done it at on a piece of paper in your notebook.
Yes, sir.
Moving to the work in pairs, check your answers. We have already done it all together, right? Okay. Question number 6th A. Put these time phrases in order. Which one you put first? From shorter to longer. Yesterday evening. And then? Very good. Then? Good.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, very good. 8 years ago, yes, very good. 80 years ago, okay. And last in the 19th century, okay. Okay, when do we use ago, last, and in? Do you have any idea? We use ago after period of time. Let me tell you some examples. I passed my matriculation about 21 years ago. I passed my matriculation 21 years ago. I had my dinner 1.5 hours ago. 1.5 hours ago. Okay. So ago is used with period of time in simple past and in the end of the sentence generally. Is it clear to everybody?
Yes.
Okay. Now moving to the word last. How to use last in a sentence? Okay. Last can be used in two ways in the simple past. He came here last Sunday. He came here last Sunday. Is it clear? Okay. I went to my nani ghar last year. I went to my nani ghar last year. Okay. And one example. First, I want to tell the Hindi sentence of that and then English, so that you may have clear idea. पिछली बार मैं अपने नानी घर तीन साल पहले गया था. पिछली बार मैं अपने नानी घर तीन साल पहले गया था. I last went to my नानी घर 3 years ago. I last went to my नानी घर 3 years ago. I hope now it is quite clear to everybody. Okay, my question to all of you. When did you last go to your nani ghar? When did you last go to your nani ghar? Means, aap apne nani ghar pichli bar kab gaye the? When did you last go? Aap pichli bar kab gaye the to your nani ghar? When did you last go? Please. In the month of March. Okay, you last went to your nani ghar 1 month ago. Okay, Prakash sir, when did you last go to your nani ghar? You missed the word last. I last went there in the month of January. Rajesh sir, when did you last go to your nani ghar? Okay, you don't have to use for. I last went there almost 2 years ago. And Mrs. Veer, when did you last go to your nani ghar? Okay. Okay, then there is no point in going there now. Okay. Manya, when did you last go to your nani ghar? Great. And Sanaya, when did you last go to your... Sanaya is not there. Rajnandini, when did you last go to your nani ghar?
Last went to my nani ghar 4 years ago.
4 years ago. So, I think it is quite clear to everybody how to use last and ago in simple past tenses. Say, tense. Yeah, Gunjan, when did you last go to your nani ghar, Gunjan? Okay, you last went to your nani ghar last year. She used last 2 times and it is correct. Okay? And we use in with the name of the months and with the name of the years. I was born in 1978. I was born in 1978. India got independence in 1947. Gandhiji was killed in the month of January. When is your birthday? Sorry, in which month is your birthday?
In August.
You got independence like India got. In the month of independence.
Huh?
I never got. Okay, your mother got independence. Freedom. Okay. Oh, what do you people say? I was born. Okay. So you are a starting of a new year, Tejaswan. Manya Prakash. Huh? Huh? Okay, so you also got independence like India got. Prakash sir, in which month were you born? November. Hi Sardi, hi Sardi. Right sir? देखिए, एवरीबडी सेड इन एंड गुंजन सेड ऑफ. आई वॉज बॉर्न ऑफ नवंबर, मैं नवंबर से जन्म ली. अभिषेक, वेन वेर यू बॉर्न? प्लीज. हेलो. ओके, यू आर ऑल्सो बॉर्न इन नवंबर. सो आई थिंक नाउ इट इज क्वाइट क्लियर टू एवरीबडी हाउ टू यूज अगो, लास्ट एंड इन. इन द सिंपलेस्ट वे पॉसिबल आई ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन इट. I hope you will now make mistakes in using these words every time you speak sentences in English. Rajesh sir, when were you born? Which, in which month? People born in November are in majority here in this virtual room. Yes. I think the remaining part of the lesson should be done tomorrow.
Yes, sir.
I hope all of you enjoyed and learned a lot of things today. Yes, of course I am, completely. I am completely charged, Mrs. He was talking to someone on his side, means in his family, and the mic was open, that's why we could listen to him saying something in Hindi. So we should say good night to each other, right? Good night, Rajesh sir, Prakash sir, Mrs. Veer, Manya, Tejas, Rajnandini, Gunjan, Abhishek, and everybody. Take good care of yourself. Mere ghar ke bagal mein corona ka. So everybody needs to be ultra careful, right? Precaution is the only remedy for this problem. Oh, good. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You're right. You're right. And nobody from my family is going out of my house. Means everybody is just, we have locked the door. We are not letting anybody in and we are not going out also. Yes, of course we are. We are. We will definitely. And we will definitely follow this suggestion. Thank you for this suggestion, sir. And really fine. I think really it is going to be very useful for everybody. So once again, good night to all. Thank you. Take care. Good night.